Hey guys, I'm Robert. Today I want to give you a quick tour of the apps on my iPhone which have AI implementations I actually use. Most of my day is about quick capture of knowledge, processing notes, organizing content, and turning raw ideas into outlines or remixing them into something else. If you're into productivity, note-taking, knowledge management, or any kind of text-heavy creative work, this should be useful. I think this landscape is changing very quickly and the next big thing could be just around the corner, but I still want to give you some solid recommendations in case you find something that may also fit your workflow. First, let me tell you about IdeaShell. The way I think about this app is this. I add a piece of context and then I can chat or perform AI requests on it. Source material comes first, AI actions come second. The cool thing here is all the different ways that we have available to add that initial content that we will use for our requests. The app has shortcuts support, widgets, you can use the share menu when you are in other apps for links, you can select and share text, you can share audio files or record directly in the app, and this will be transcribed. If you add a YouTube link, it will pull the full transcript automatically, and once you already have something in here, you got some cards that are like preset actions. You can create your own, but many times I will just ask directly. Something nice is that you can even activate DeepThink for more in-depth results. IdeaShell comes with a companion Apple Watch app, and this is so good. It has replaced another automation I shared a while back for AI transcriptions on the go. It has a complication that starts recording with one tap, but if my hands are not free, I can start recording by double tapping my fingers. I use this for dictating thoughts when I'm outside. Some of my best ideas come when I least expect them, so having this with me at all times is amazing. I can also stop in exactly the same way. Later in the day, I can open the app on my phone and it will transcribe what I dictated. Not only does it transcribe, but it automatically does a cleanup pass with AI. And if your audio is longer than 10 minutes, it automatically gives you a speaker-separated transcription. So this is also great for meetings since you can ask for key points by speaker and with timestamps as well. By the way, something I find super handy is that if I have several recordings that I did throughout the day and they are all related, I can merge them all into one piece of context and then perform my AI requests on that. This app has many other features I haven't mentioned. Many of them are related to note-taking and organization, but if you already have a solid note-taking system like I do somewhere else, you don't have to use this for storing stuff on the long run. I still find it very convenient to use as sort of a workspace where I process content and then I share out whatever I need to other apps. At the time of recording this, IdeaShell offers a lifetime option that I think is absolutely worth it. If you have followed this channel for a while, you may know that I'm a bit of a nerd when it comes to dictation apps. Being able to speak ideas and control how they get transformed into text with the help of AI has been quite revolutionary for my productivity. On my iPhone, especially when I'm dictating into other apps, the tool I have been using for this is Spokenly. Just to quickly tell you how this works, there's the transcription process where your words become text, then there's the AI processing where the text is sent to AI for formatting. In Spokenly, you have access to many transcription models, both cloud and local. If you have a transcription service with an OpenAI compatible API, you can also plug that in. Same with the LLM that handles post-processing. On my Mac, I use an AI assistant app called Alter, so I can use those models in Spokenly via the custom provider option. Here, I have total control over the prompt and can set advanced parameters like reasoning effort or temperature. But what makes this even more useful is that you have access to all of this directly through its own keyboard. Because of iOS limitations, you need Spokenly running in the background, which is why, depending on your front app, automatic switching to activate dictation may or may not be supported. In this case, I am using Bear, which does it automatically. If not, all you need to do is swipe at the bottom. This is a minor downside, which truly is nothing compared to what you get. Once you start recording, you can select one of your custom AI prompts, but a lot of times I select no prompt because it's super fast with some models. I just tap insert and my text is already there. The keyboard also lets you run AI prompts on text that's already in your application. I can select this option, for example, that organizes everything in bullet points. The developer of Spokenly is one of the most responsive I have ever seen. Almost every piece of feedback I have given has been implemented, and it's a level of commitment that is rare and amazing. Now, the craziest thing of all of this is that if you use the app with local models or with your own API tokens, it is totally free. I cannot recommend it enough. I also have Superwhisper on my phone, which is another AI dictation app similar to Spokenly. I use this one mainly for long brainstorming sessions, like when I'm working through a project and I want to get everything out of my head. If I'm on my desk, sometimes I like to stand up, stretch, and walk around the house while dictating directly to the app, which helps my ideas flow better. Because of the handoff feature on Apple devices, the text shows up on my clipboard as soon as it's processed and it's ready to paste on my desktop. Superwhisper has a keyboard too, but it's much more basic. You cannot switch modes. There's several bugs that I continue to encounter, and the overall workflow feels clunky. To be honest, Spokenly can do almost everything that Superwhisper does on mobile. Perhaps it can even do more. The only thing is that Spokenly doesn't offer unlimited AI processing, and that's what keeps me using Superwhisper in the way that I just told you. Only because the OpenAI or Claude models that came with a lifetime purchase is something that I like to take advantage of. I really want this app to improve on iOS, but right now the only reason I would recommend it is if you plan to use it primarily on your Mac. On iOS, it's okay. It's fast, it's handy, and I use it every day, but it still has a very long way to go. Now, I want to tell you about Snipd. This is what I use whenever I am listening to podcasts or long-form audio. It is built with the idea of using AI to quickly help you extract knowledge. It's incredible because I can see AI-generated summaries before listening. It creates chapters so that I can quickly jump to different sections. It automatically pulls out quotes. It will detect the guests that appear so I can easily find related content. If there's any mentions of books, I can quickly find them. And one of the core features is the ability to create highlights, or how the application calls it, snips. I am listening to something and all I have to do is double tap my earphones. It will use AI to detect what insight was playing at the time, and it will highlight that specific section. I still do some manual adjustments, but overall it's very accurate. I only follow a few podcasts regularly, but I love listening to interviews or lectures on many different topics. So what really makes this app so much more valuable for me is that you can directly share YouTube links or upload your own audio. The app will use AI to transcribe this, and you will have access to all those features that I already mentioned. One more AI feature is the ability to directly chat or ask things related to the content of what you are listening. I truly think that Snipd is amazing and a great example of how to use AI effectively for learning and self-development. You might notice some of this AI chat functionality in Snipd starts to overlap with IdeaShell that I mentioned before. The way I see it, IdeaShell is an app that can do many things well when it comes to interacting with a piece of content or generating something new out of it. It's just extremely versatile. But Snipd is more for serious, focused content consumption. Reader is my inbox and reading space for almost every piece of media I consume. Articles, PDFs, newsletters, RSS feeds, even books or YouTube videos that I plan to watch. It all lands in Reader first. Here I organize, read, and highlight stuff every day, and this Read It Later app is an integral part of my knowledge management system. Reader has one AI feature called Ghost Reader. This is a set of one-off prompts that you can run on the content in front of you. You can ask questions, explain a paragraph, define terms, simplify a section. I don't use Ghost Reader a lot because some of the other apps I have on my phone or desktop already covered me for doing AI requests on content, but there's one thing that makes this useful for specific cases. This AI can access whatever highlights you already did on the content and any notes that you have added in the app. Every Saturday, I spend time reviewing what I consumed during the week. If I find a piece I highlighted that was particularly insightful, I take time to add some personal notes or thoughts on the side. Then I use one prompt that grabs my highlights, plus the content, plus my personal thoughts, and I use this to help me draft something to share on my newsletter. It helps me structure my ideas on whatever I read in a better way. Another AI feature of Reader that I love and that I use more often is the text-to-speech. It uses AI to generate an audio version of whatever content you got in there. It is very convenient for listening instead of reading. Readwise is a companion app that comes with Reader. This is where everything I highlight ends up, and the AI features here are pretty unique. An essential part of my everyday routine is doing a quick highlights review. Readwise uses AI to generate an audio version of five things that I stored in the past and place them with this very realistic voice plus a bit of commentary. Whenever possible, I like to listen while I'm reading in the app at the same time, because if something stands out, I can pause the audio for a moment, make a section bold or highlight it. I can also tag or add personal notes right there. The other feature, which I think is amazing, is their chat with your highlights. Since I take highlights from everything I consume, I can come in here and quickly find that piece of content. I just cannot remember where it came from. For example, hey, help me find a highlight about designing tools and the importance of leaving room for other people to build on top of them. It's amazing for stuff like this or for finding connections. It really is like search on steroids. Here I got exactly what I was looking for, and if I want, I can open the sidebar and I can find related stuff. I can also use this to assist me in creating content based on stuff I already captured. For example, hey, I plan to write a short article on the importance of choosing the right tools when it comes to productivity. I want you to find some related highlights that you can reference to ask me five questions that can inspire me or make me consider different perspectives. I think this is so good for remixing ideas or coming up with new insights. AI features like the ones in Readwise make all the highlighting and organizing I do totally worth it. For quick AI interactions on my phone, I use an app called Apollo by Liquid. It's simple, but it covers a few things that I couldn't find anywhere else. I needed something that would let me use models from OpenAI compatible endpoints so that I could plug those LLMs provided by Alter and OpenRouter. I also wanted something that didn't require a subscription and had shortcut integration for faster, more convenient interactions across my entire system. I use it in two ways. First, I have set a shortcut with some preset prompts that I can tap directly. My wife is Chinese, so I have some prompts that I use whenever I encounter a word or an idea where I think AI can do a better job at explaining when there's cultural context or idioms that don't translate literally. No matter what I'm doing or the app that I'm using, I get my response right there. I can close it, or if I want, I can continue the conversation in the app. The other way I use this is for sharing text directly to the shortcut. For example, let's say that I'm reviewing a highlight on Readwise and want to use AI to simplify it. I just share it over. The result is always on my clipboard so I can quickly paste. I also use this to help me draft email replies. This is something I mostly do on my desktop with other apps, but it's handy to also have it on mobile. I select some text, tap select all, share it to the shortcut, and I have this answer prompt where I can draft a super quick reply. Apollo will expand it. Like I told you, this app is quite minimal and there are a few more features that I wish it had, but it's still really useful. And the most amazing part is that it's totally free and it has a desktop app, so requests that I make on my phone can also sync right over. All of those apps I have mentioned until now are the ones that I use the most, but I still want to give you a few honorable mentions. I have TypingMind, which is a more advanced chat interface that lets me use many different AI models, similar to what Apollo does. The biggest downside here is that it's a web app, so I cannot connect it with shortcuts or get that deeper integration with other apps. I still use TypingMind for image generation or when I'm working on longer content between my computer and phone, because it has some advanced features that come in handy, like the ability to use plugins and agents. And one last special mention. I have Craft on my phone, and among other things, I use it to store content related to projects, task management, and sharing documents as web pages. Craft has a built-in AI that works as single-pass actions. You can run this on selected blocks of text or your entire document. With just a few taps, you can summarize, translate, expand, simplify, or continue writing in the same voice. The app is beautifully designed and the AI feature is really well done, but since I already have IdeaShell and Apollo doing similar things with more flexibility, I usually reach for those instead. That said, if you're looking for a note-taking or document app that has a solid AI assistant baked right in, Craft might be worth checking out. It's nice having everything in one place without jumping between tools. I know that I'm probably missing something here. Like I mentioned before, all of this AI technology is changing very fast. So if you know of anything better, or if there's an AI app on your phone that you find essential and is solving something for you, I would love to know. I'm always looking for recommendations. Also, some of these apps are very powerful and I know that I could do a deeper dive. So if you're curious about specific workflows or features in anything that I have mentioned, just let me know. I am happy to consider it for future content. I'll put links to all the apps in the description so you can try them yourself. Thank you so much for watching. Remember, you can always sign up to my newsletter for more updates on what I'm up to. I hope this was useful. Talk to you soon.